Pad-2 has begun its first significant test run in preparation for the upcoming V3 flight scheduled for later this year. This exciting new version of Starship features a variety of upgraded components that are already visible at Star Factory. Let's discuss them all in today's episode of NR Studio. The launch infrastructure is evolving alongside the new version of Starship, and Pad-2 is now the most prominent symbol of this development. For several months, efforts have been underway to ensure Pad-2 reaches full operational status. The main structure was completed some time ago, and in recent weeks, final details have been added. These latest adjustments indicate that Pad-2 has entered the testing phase, preparing to support the inaugural V3 flight. Once that flight occurs, Pad-2 will serve as the primary launch site for the entire Starship initiative. A significant milestone was reached on September 13th when SpaceX activated the Fire Deluge system on Pad-2. Witnesses observed controlled jets of water rising near the launch tower, marking the debut of the long-awaited Water Deluge system. This event follows extensive work on a new water tank, which has been developed to support the massive power required for a Starship launch. Initially, the water flow seemed weaker than anticipated, but this was related to the unique design of the trench. Unlike Launch Pad 1, which used water-cooled steel plates that created a noticeable backflow, the Launch Pad 2 trench disperses the water differently. It's also possible that the system didn't operate at full capacity during its initial operation. Rather, this marks the beginning of a careful and detailed testing process. More intensive activations are expected soon, especially with the planned road closure on September 16th, which coincides with potential follow-up tests. If these tests go as planned, they may soon demonstrate that the trench system is operating at the full power required to manage Starship's powerful thrust. The fire trench is a key innovation for Launch Pad 2. Its dual bucket design, combined with a deluge system, is designed to absorb and redirect the extreme heat and pressure generated during launch. This design isn't just designed to survive a single launch, it's designed to withstand multiple violent launches over many years. SpaceX first tested this type of system at its facility in Macy, but the version on Launch Pad 2 has been significantly improved. With two fire buckets instead of just one, its capacity to effectively disperse energy doubles. In many ways, Launch Pad 2 sets the standard for all future Starship launch pads, from Starbase to Cape Canaveral and beyond. In terms of recent developments, additional systems have begun operating. That same weekend, Pad 2's gas system briefly activated, causing a brief release of exhaust gas. While not significant, this indicates that a larger and more extensive exhaust release test is imminent. Mechanical components also continue to be evaluated. The giant blowpipe arm, added earlier this year, has been through various movements, raising, lowering, opening, and closing, to ensure it functions properly to stack or capture Starship components. Furthermore, the quick disconnect QD booster has been activated, indicating another crucial system is nearly ready for operation. Testing is proceeding rapidly, and rightly so, as Pad 2 will be the primary launch site once Starship evolves into the V3 version. Current estimates suggest that the first flight could occur before the end of the year, with December being the most likely month if the 11th flight occurs without significant problems in October. Meanwhile, the V3 hardware is progressing rapidly. The first new prototype, B18, is nearing completion and is expected to begin testing soon. Its companion, S39, is also nearing completion and will soon be ready for stacking. Coordination between the vehicle and infrastructure is crucial, and SpaceX is clearly working hard to align it with its ambitious schedule. The V3 launch will be more than a minor upgrade. It will be a significant breakthrough. Musk has called this redesign groundbreaking, as nearly every aspect of the rocket has been upgraded or changed. Such extensive changes require an evolution of the supporting infrastructure. Pad 2 is more than just a launch pad. It has been designed to support higher thrust, heavier payloads, and more frequent flights. The focus has shifted from Pad 2's readiness to how quickly it can prove its capabilities. In the coming weeks, the deluge system can be tested at full capacity, the fire trench can be pushed to its limits, and the pad's critical systems may undergo final validation. Each test brings SpaceX one step closer to fully realizing the potential of Starship S39. The arrival of Pad 2 marks more than just a technical achievement. It demonstrates SpaceX's commitment to continuous improvement and innovative design. Just as the rocket evolves through testing and refinement, its supporting infrastructure continues to evolve. Launch Pad 2 not only represents a leap forward for Starbase, but also serves as a model for the global Starship network that SpaceX envisions. The launch site is bustling with activity, with the spacecraft nearing completion and the first innovative Starship prototype nearly ready for flight. With Launch Pad 2 right next door, V3 will mark a new chapter for the program. The countdown to the future has begun, and the world will soon see what this new combination of rocket and launch pad can accomplish. V3 is nearing release, marking one of the most significant advancements in Starship's journey so far. Musk has emphasized that this edition will be a complete overhaul, sparking great excitement within the space community. Over the past year, numerous updates have been shared, each pointing the way toward a fully reusable, next-generation launch system. Confirmed improvements so far include new Raptor 3 engines, a revised fin grid design, improved booster recovery points, the implementation of hot staging, and the addition of a fuel transfer canister for orbital refueling. All of these innovations address critical aspects of reusability, collectively paving the way for Starship to achieve incredible milestones previously thought impossible. Recently, new insights from the Star Factory production area have emerged, illustrating the extent of these modifications. Photos show a tank with a unique column and header structure compared to previous designs. While the header resembles previous tanks, the column appears smaller than a typical main tank, raising the possibility that it is a new header tank custom built for the spacecraft. If confirmed, it would mark a significant evolution from the currently used circular header tanks. Weighing about 5 tons, this part may be small, but it represents a significant advancement in improving Starship's effectiveness. Another exciting component has emerged, located at the rear of the prototype. This larger tank weighs about 10,000 pounds, or about 4.5 tons. Its size suggests that SpaceX is working diligently to expand the limits of Starship's capacity and efficiency. Each change represents a vehicle that not only has more power, but also greater flexibility in carrying out its missions. Overall, these updates highlight SpaceX's unwavering commitment to improving every element of Starship. The launch of V3 later this year will mark the beginning of a transformative chapter in the program, marked by innovative redesigns and ambitious goals. The only question that remains is whether the world is ready for the latest and most advanced version of Starship. As Starship progresses rapidly, SpaceX remains focused on one of its primary responsibilities, resupplying the International Space Station. On September 14th at 6:11 p.m. Eastern Time, a Falcon 9 lifted off from Cape Canaveral's SLC-40, carrying Northrop Grumman's Cygnus spacecraft into orbit. The operation went perfectly, with the Falcon 9 booster landing back at LZ-2, while Cygnus successfully lifted off and began its journey to the ISS. The spacecraft is expected to reach its destination after 60 hours, arriving at 6:35 a.m. on September 17th. Unlike Dragon, which docks itself, Cygnus will be captured by the Canadarm2 robotic arm and attached to the station. That's it for today's episode. See you in the next one.